27, A few more. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, 27 ya. Morning you on about 27 lah. You all this morning ya, yeah? As of now. I think kita mula lah kot ya. Jahan dah quite, apa ni, quite a lot for me to cover juga lah this morning. So, I hope nothing happens to bear with me. I think kita, for this also, you all ada kelas ya. Okay. Kita akan slowly we let the apa, yang datang lambat tu apa ni. To join kita. Selamat puasa ya, tudus kan yang ni yang mestinya ada. Kita start off ya, boleh. Awalnya di sini. Okay, week 6 ni, we'll look into two of the marketing mix. Yeah, we'll be looking at pricing and promotion because next week I'll be covering the marketing strategies, a bit of that, yeah, for us to just understand, yeah, what would be the strategies that we like to adopt, yeah, kalau kita looking into the promotion, yeah, looking into marketing. Some things that we offer. There are many more actually things that I have come up recently and whatnot. Tapi itulah just the basis of understanding first of what it is, eh? Then baru nampak new concepts and all lah, will be coming in. Ya, tak apa untuk ni. Okay. Ya, what's important is actually, kan kita dah look into product, cuma place tu a bit of apa sikit lah, because in our case of property, kita place tu, there are many ways that you could apa kan, describe place, ya. Yeah? So place ni is something which where the customer can be able to find your apa kan, your product. Yeah? So property ni kadang-kadang people will just zoom in into location of where you can find, eh? Where the development is. Yeah? But it's also a place whereby potential buyers would be able to reach out, maybe kan, kata maybe can the website can be one way of reaching out, yeah, or maybe your site office punya showroom, or your maybe sales office that you put up in exhibitions all over the country. So this one way of many place a bit upper sikit, yeah, for the property development punya product. Yeah. For this particular week, we're looking into pricing and promotion. And the promotion ni ada a bit of element of selling. Yeah, selling is where the estate agent and the personal sellers, yeah, yang like to promote maybe the housing development punya products, ya, yeah, houses that they develop, ya, yeah, to potential customers. Okay, we'll be looking into price and promotion. So what is important is that what is price sebenarnya? How do you define price? And we'll be looking into the few strategies dalam price, in the main price. And what would how do price change? And what would be the product pricing elements that we're looking for property? Yeah? Then we look into promotion, yeah, element of promotion mix. Promotion mix ni apa? Selalu macam kalau saya tanya apa dia promotion mix yang ada yang boleh digunakan, atau mix can also be interchangeably used. The term be used from mix and tools. Apakah alat atau campuran promosi yang boleh digunakan, ya? Yeah? So these are, yeah, of the apa ni? The ways that you maybe want to describe. Eh? Tapi jangan don't get apa apa ni? Jangan takut. To help to explain, ya. Yeah? Apakah campuran promosi yang boleh digunakan untuk memasarkan harta tanah tersebut? Okay, what would be the promotion mix or tools that can be used, ya? Yeah? Untuk memasarkan kan harta tanah dalam dalam pembangunan harta tanah di satu di apalah oleh siapa-siapa macam Dabi, Gak Muda, SP Sofia, Eco World dan sebagainya. Yeah. So this kan jangan takut lah with the terms yang apa kan promotion mix, promotion tools, they are interchangeably di apa saling bertukar-tukar guna the term being used. Yeah. Okay, let us look now at price. Harga. Yeah. Price is the only element dalam marketing mix that produces revenue. All other elements represent cost. Yeah? Produk, nak membuat produk itu kita kena keluarkan cost. Nah, juga untuk tempat, yeah, place. Yeah? Whereby mana kita nak menempatkan produk itu supaya dia accessible to our customers, kita juga kena keluarkan cost. Itu juga dengan promosi. Kena ada budget, yeah, untuk kita buat promosi. Semua price is just the only element dalam marketing mix tadi yang produces revenue, ya, yeah, kepada kepada orang yang membuat produk tersebut, ya. Yeah. So we must always try to understand what would be the perception of value to your customers. Apakah konsep harga dan nilai, ya, yang penting nilai lah kepada kepada kita punya pelanggan, ya, yeah, our main customers, ya, yeah, pelanggan. Yeah, so it's very important untuk kita faham how much value the consumer place on the benefits they receive from the product. Apakah dia kan kebaikan dia boleh dapat daripada produk yang dia beli ni, ya. Yeah? So kita mesti faham, betul faham, ya. Yeah? That's when then they set a price that captures the value. Ya, yeah? Adakah kan harga yang terletak kepada rumah tersebut mempunyai nilai kepada, tapi cuma kita dalam in terms of property development, ya, harga nilai tu, nilai yang diletakkan oleh consumer tu kadang-kadang depending on telah banyak-banyak things lah, ya, because we set a harga, a price for that particular tu, tapi itulah developers must have set the price based on a certain things, ya, that they have accounted, ya, we will discuss that later, ha, in the following apa ni, slide nanti, ya. Semua you kena capture juga for you to be able to now develop, there must be an understanding of who would be your potential customers. That's very very important, yeah. Who are you targeting? Kita dah buat segmentation, market targeting, market positioning kan yang earlier lecture. Okay, who are you targeting your development to? Siapa target, target customers kita, yeah. The new apa house purchasers, the young Gen Y, younger generations that have started working, or the older generation, M40, P20. So these are the demographic information that you may want to analyze for you to be able to now apa target to whom you are trying to market your product to. Yeah. Okay, and price have many names. It can be in terms of rent that relates to us. Yeah. Sewa. Tapi boleh juga sewa perkakasan. Sekarang in the office, kita orang sewa je ada photo set machine, eh, in the offices. No longer purchase, ya. Yeah. To us, it's much more cheaper. In terms of maintenance, we just ask the apa kan, those yang list that apa that equipment to us to just kalau rosak ganti ataupun betulkan. That is one. Tapi rental in terms of the space that we rent out to people to others, the owner does that to get the income sometimes then can be informed of the potential income of the investment that he has actually intended to have for the property or property. Then maybe tuition, the payment that you pay for a certain amount of services rendered by this particular person to give tuition to your children, probably to your sister dan sebagainya. Fair, untuk harga tiket, untuk naik dalam bas, terbang, rate, the rate that you may charge for your hotel room rates dan sebagainya. Commission being paid out for maybe the asset agent dapat commission for the for the transaction that is being completed. Wage in terms of kita punya gaji fee that fee is being charged of our consultancy fee valuation fee as the agent fee dues apa yang maknanya yang perlu dibayar what is due of the payment to be made by particular person interest interest that we kita can can collect of putting our money in the fixed deposit dan sebagainya. Donation yang kita donate to people dan sebagainya. Salary sama wage jadi kurang salary, the amount of money that you can be able to get for every fixed period of time that is being upon between the employer and the employee. So these are the many terms that's being placed. Because salary tu maybe the kind of price is being paid by the employer for that employee punya services. So something yang kita kena be able to comprehend, faham? The steps in setting prices, this is just the general steps in setting prices lah, it can, the process can be a bit more complicated to some, products yang being being put up into market. Okay, first select the pricing objective. Why do you like to put up that price? Anyone? Determine your demand. That's always a case to belajar supply and demand dalam belajar economics. This is when economics comes into play, the understanding of economics. Estimate the cost that's been involved. Of course, most those who like to put up products in the market, they mesti nak recoup the cost of dia buat the product. Saya pun, kalau saya nak jual something, saya nak juga recoup the cost of saya jual baju, for the kain, for the jahitan and whatnot, for the services dan saya upah orang tu dan sebagainya. For me to transport to where it can be to put up dalam booth dan sebagainya. All these costs are being involved. Then you look at you analyze your competitors' cost, prices and offers. Pun satu. Are the competitor setting the same price or slightly lower than what we intend to put? Akan kita nak. Then for us to compete, you must be at the same level or even competitively put the competitive price to our proposed product. And you select a pricing method, either ways that you can select, and select the final price. Then it will be the final price. Okay, in terms of strategy, saya selalu juga tanya dalam soalan test ataupun exam, probably a bit, what would be the strategies that you can adopt in determining the pricing strategies of a particular product. There are three actually main strategies. One would be the new product pricing strategies. Second will be product mix pricing strategies. And thirdly will be price adjustment strategies. Saya selalu tanya new product pricing strategies. Because these are just common things that probably you may want to capture. Because normally this would be the main thing that I think most developers also be looking, kalau nak face the new development, what would be the strategy that they can adopt, Because kita property ni not the same as the typical consumer product, Okay, the new pricing strategies yang saya mentioned earlier tadi, there are two strategies under A. Saya nak you all ingat A, B, C. A tu apa? For you to remember. I'm trying to help you to now understand that nanti tak ada confuse dan sebagainya. Okay, under new product pricing strategies, there are two main strategies. One is market screening pricing. Second will be market penetration pricing. Yeah. Okay, now what is market screening pricing? Market scheme. Ingat tu, market scheme. It's a strategy for setting a high price for new product to scheme maximum revenue layer by layer from segments willing to pay the high price. The company makes few but more profitable seats. Yeah, because the support for them to use this market skimming pricing will be the product quality and image. They must support the price. Buyers must want the product at that price. Yeah, the cost of producing the price in small volume should not cancel the advantages of higher prices, and competitors should not be able to enter the market easily. Yeah, sebab competitor nak buat ni, it will cost them money. Yeah, a lot of money actually. Yeah, so a good example of this, example dulu lah. Sony at one time, yeah, they introduced the world first high definition television to the Japanese market. The high tech set cost $43,000. So this television was purchased only by customer who really want the new technology and afford to pay higher prices. In the case of telephone, yeah, so I'm thinking Apple at one time. What was the price when they first launched? Yeah, and masa tu ada tak competitor for Apple punya product. Later on, slowly the other kan phone companies come in and try to come in with lower price punya product to compete. But still, I think people who really appreciate the quality and the Apple the feature that Apple phones offer, they will stick to using Apple phones, to think. So no harm, so they adopt this market scheme pricing. Okay, the second one, market penetration pricing. Tadi market scheming, now market penetration. Tadi scheme kat atas saja. Ini sekarang dia nak masuk, market penetration pricing. They set a low initial price in order to penetrate the market quickly and deeply to attract large number of buyers quickly to gain market share. Dia set low price sebab dia nak penetrate market quickly. Dia nak biar orang datang and buy. So it's actually very competitive pricing. Low upper price. It's a price sensitive market. Maknanya dia pergi market yang memang orang will buy product yang ada harga yang murah. So kita tengok segmen mana you entering. Production distribution cost must fall as sale volumes increases. Maknanya kan bila sale volume increase, your production distribution cost will tend to fall. And low prices must keep competition out of the market. So maknanya dalam market competition ni, low prices ni will try to keep competition out of the market. Kalau boleh. Tapi cuma to me, market competition ni, you must be strong to be able to capture and compete with your competitor. In the case of Malaysia, I would see Maidin. Maidin hypermarket is one that is competing. I think Tesco now dah tukar jadi Lotus. We'll see. Giant, I don't know how they're going to compete. Dulu Jusco, now Aeon Big has taken over. So you can try to try to observe the changes in the retailing, especially consumer products in your retail. Okay, for example, Dell at one time used penetration pricing to enter the personal computer market, selling high quality computer products to lower cost direct channel. But now I think Dell also has banyak competitor dah masuk. So Dell ni macam dia ada just a bit of the market dia yang still within they focus on something else, not offering personal computer. Banyak ada HP dan sebagainya. Product mix pricing strategies. Okay, saya tak berapa ni. I just put it for you all to know. Okay, what are the product mix ya? Remember what product mix is? Campuran yang ada dalam satu satu organisation yang menjual pelbagai jenis produk dalam dia punya dalam dia punya production. As product line pricing, optional product pricing, captive product pricing, by product pricing and product bundle pricing. Okay, for sale, okay, saya just for you to know, for sale price adjustment pricing, okay, this is when you come in to adjust, ya. Yeah. Strategi yang digunakan untuk kita buat a bit of adjustment, whereby you can include discount and allowances pricing, or you buat segmented pricing, psychological pricing, promotional pricing, geographic pricing, dynamic pricing, and international pricing. These are some adjustment that you could do to strategize your pricing that you have set. The cost diminished of price, and the marginal cost, average fixed cost, average variable cost, average total cost. I think budget all these kind of economics before. Yeah? The steps in setting the right price, you mentioned that maybe you want to establish your pricing goals, estimate demand, cost, and profit. Choose the strategy, fine-tune base price, and then set the right price. The price changes, why do you do price changes? Because you want to boost sales and kalau boleh, there's price cut lah, yeah? And price increases. You can tend to increase the prices because you see that, kalau you increase pun, there'll be no changes, the price in elasticity. Yeah? It's not very high. If I naik sikit pun, demand can maintain the same. Yeah, all depends. The price cut occurs due to excess capacity or increased market share. Yeah, and price increase. Yeah, from cost inflation, increased demand, and lack of supply. Yeah, bila nampak tak ada supply of that particular product, you nampak the price tend to increase because people would have to just to buy, yeah, because tak ada dah supply. Macam at one time macam MCO lah, for example, yeah. People tend to now pergi try to find ni lah, apa yang kata-kata mask, yeah. Kita tunjuk muka. Masa there were not many suppliers, so lack of supply. Nampak harga mask then was how much, yeah. Luckily, we were staying inside, yeah, most of the time. Kena keluar, kena pakai mask tu lah. Yeah. But now, I think the price has really dropped, yeah, because there's an increased supply. This is something that we can learn to, yeah. Okay, pricing. The price increases. Price is hot. That means that, better made. And maybe the company's really bigger. Price cut because of new models will be available. Models are not selling well. And maybe quality issues is what the organization can do. Yeah. So questions you can post for price changes. Why did the competitor change the price? You may want to know why the competitor suddenly wants to change the price. Yeah. Or is the price cut permanent or temporary? What's the effect on market share and profits? Will the competitor respond if you change your price? Yeah. So there are things that these are the questions that you may want to post. Yeah. Solution, you may want to reduce price to match competition. Maybe you want to maintain the price but raise the perceived value to competitions. Yeah. You may want to improve quality and increase price, or you want to launch a low price fighting brand. So these are why, okay? Maybe price changes and maybe solutions also to meet the price changes. Okay, responding to price changes, these are some things that you may want to post the questions. Yeah? Has competitor cut the price? Well, no. What can you do? You hold your current price, continue to monitor competitor price. Yeah. Has competitor cut the price? Yes. So will lower price and take effect our market share and profit? No. So what you do is that you hold your current price. Tapi kalau kata, has competitor cut the price and can or should take action be taken? Kalau no, you hold. Kalau yes, this is something yang maybe kan. You may want to see balik your situation in your particular organization. You want to reduce price, you want to raise perceived value, you would like to improve quality and future prices, or launch new price fighting brand value, yeah, yang saya mentioned earlier. So this I think may be ways that you could respond to price changes. Okay, product pricing property. Nah, okay, like in the aspect of property, the most product development project you nampak, they have multi-products, yeah, and pricing involves product line than a single product, yeah. When developers consider a particular product line, that product cannot be priced in isolation from the rest, yeah, because there are Banyak kan, macam kalau dia buat terrace houses pun ada at one time tu yang mention, developer dia buat terrace houses tapi dia punya, dia ada design design lain-lain. And itulah lain-lain tu in terms maybe of the size of the house or maybe particularly maybe what do what they include in terms of finishing right, that particular house. So you kena really monitor kan, why you put a certain apa kan, changes apa, differentiation of the price between one to the other. Dia kena really apa ni, and you tengok the pricing tu cannot isolate lah, you kena compare. The price then has to be viewed in NT, and different product serve different purpose but come together to benefit the whole. Something that maybe kita kena apa, view dia apa, the whole in an entity. Keseluruhan sekali kita kena, kena apa ni, tema ya kita punya ni pricing. Yeah. So because you may want to see that the product of that particular development company serve many segment. Yeah. One product to earn a relatively low price while the other is skimming. You could do that. Yeah. Because tapi most developer saya nampak, saya observe. Yeah. Dia punya tu dia tend to macam saya dan saya gambar new product tends to be in a particular range of prices. Yeah. Tak pernah saya nampak price dia go below a certain ni lah, certain price. Unless kan that particular developer is developing low cost houses, which I think some developer tak nak. What they could do, you know, kalau dulu some state government impose, yeah, for a certain development there must be certain percentage of the content to be low cost punya houses. Yeah, but some developer what could do is that they pay back and tell the government what they can do, that they find another piece of land somewhere where they can do the low cost development. Sebab dia nak dalam dia campuran punya tu will be those yang maybe high end, dia tak nak campur dengan low end punya properties. Yeah. That's one way of also trying to brand the development. It's something which we can ponder and apa lah, and put up the question back to the state government in terms of dia punya approval. Yeah. Okay, so a high quality product may require a high price to establish a prestige position in the marketplace and to satisfy management profit performance requirement, while a relatively low quality product may be sold just above the cost. Dan kalau ada lah, so kita tengok balik di management punya profit performance requirement. So how much of kan profit that you like to actually make this year? Tengoklah dalam punya kan, dalam apa, newspaper cuttings of that particular developer that you've chosen, yeah? Or press release, websites, yeah? It's all there in Mr. Google. Yeah, Mr. Google tolong kita baca, kan? Okay? I think we've gone through that case last week, Mr. Google, and how it helps everybody, yeah? Okay. The price strategy, kan, the total mix strategy whereby competitive pricing is seen as the most appropriate strategy dalam, kan, dalam mix strategy. Dalam mana lah, in practice, most developers set prices based on cost plus approach, but they adjust these prices according to market competition. Yeah, selalunya memang, actually, most of the time, we will try to make sure that we cover the cost. Siapa tak nak, ya, yeah, if anything, like cover the cost that we have actually, kita dah guna, kita dah buat, ya, yeah, dan kita nak cover balik cost yang kita telah ni buat tadi, ya. Yeah. Analyzes product mix, design, actually marketing manager analyze product mix, design strategy, product quality and features to mean the effect of these factors on price strategy, yeah. So dia akan analyze all this, yeah. Okay, the main elements of revision strategy, kalau kita tengok dalam solution in terms of place juga, yeah, that you could also adopt, yeah. Type of revision strategy and channel combination also influence price strategy, yeah. The same product line marketed to conventional marketing approach have different infrastructure compared to if they are marketed to multi-level market approach. Yeah. So the intensity distribution also determine infrastructure. Aggressive marketing can set higher price. Passive marketing probably set lower price. Yeah. And as a property developer can apply active market strategy and manage the distribution channel, yeah, price strategy for entire channel require optimum price structure in each channel, yeah. And price is the key element in entire marketing strategy. So price sebenarnya actually the main, yeah, kalau you nak market your product. secantik mana pun, you know, ada produk with good good configuration sebagainya, all your channel punya pun, bagus promotion you buat, tapi all depends as well. The bottom line is the price. What is the value of kan value ni to your potential customer? What, how much value they put in certain elements yang dia nak to the product that you're going to offer in the market. That's something you got to find. Kata itu yang seeking and understanding the value is the most important thing sebenarnya. That's what marketing experts apa ni pandai in trying to determine that the value. Kita as valuers, kita value lain ini value of the benefits dan sebagainya is the one yang kita kena understand within marketing punya aspect. Okay, to most property buyers, price represents the value product they buy. Buyers look at functional, quality, operational, financial, personal aspect that can attach to the product. Functional, tengok product design, ability dia to fulfill the desired function. Beli rumah, apa dia punya fungsi? Fungsi rumah tersebut. Untuk beri tempat teduh, add as a home to the family, tempat di mana your family will interact, have rest, place whereby they could place whereby they could use it to go out to mana pula, what would be the fungsi, function of that product. Quality, prices also reflect quality but may not be reflective of quality due to locational factors because kadang banyak perkara yang tetapkan harga rumah ini something which can be because can be research on sebenarnya tapi dah lama kita tak really apakah yang menentukan harga sesebuah rumah yang good atau tidak. Operational, adakah rumah tersebut ada ready built-in cabinet or renovated that you can terus do activities within the house. Tak payah tunggu dan pasang what not. Financial punya perspektif can be assisted with the property purchase price gain terms of higher rental or retail price when value appreciate dan sebagainya. So dalam aspek kewangan, of course the buyer will tengok harga rumah tapi tengok juga dia punya apa dia boleh gain. Okay, dalam in the shorter and the long term lah. Shorter, kalau dia tak nak duduk situ, dia receive berapa banyak. Berapa ni yang dia dapat. Bila kalau nak resell balik kan, apa resell value dia boleh dapat. Resell price Kalau kita tahu value appreciate over time. And maybe some personal aspect prices need to gauge product against intangible psychological and physical benefit. Or the benefits related to status, self-image, lifestyle. And dalam personal aspect ni saya nak duduk rumah Sam, duduk rumah dekat masjid. Sam duduk rumah dekat sekolah untuk anak dia. Sam duduk rumah dekat hospital. Sam duduk rumah sebab dekat dengan tempat kerja. And those days to be the British, during the British time sebelum kita merdeka dan apa, some development saya observe, nampak staff housing yang dia buat untuk government quarters sebagainya, dia buat tu because dia fikir nak memudahkan pekerja bekerja di tempat yang dekat dengan tempat dia tinggal. Tapi now with the advancement of technology, you can work from home or because of the benefits of the transportation system. Whereby you boleh nampak kalau dulu masih you wanted to do the high speed rail dan sebagainya. So I think with this jalan dalam pemandu dulu. Kalau you all know, kalau you google pemandu, they will put it up and putting in the benefits of the high speed rail dan sebagainya and MRT. So that they kata people can just, people living outside now or away from where you work can commute easily by having a good transportation system. So these are things you tengok So what can actually influence your buyer's perception in terms of the offering and looking into what purchases want for the value of the product they are taking. So things, these are things that you want to see. Okay, pricing objective, these are the typical pricing objective. Saya mungkin tanya, ya. What would be the apa, typical objective of pricing? First, return on investment. Yeah. Means of achieving a specific rate of return of investment over a period of time. Yeah. What is the period generate profit mean dari? Yeah. If the period is long, the company will build products strategically, create and protect market share to plan market penetration with strong marketing support. Kita tengok bila nak dapatkan balik our return of investment. Paling cepat ke, lama ke, dan kena, dalam tu kena try apa ni kalau period tu panjang ya. Yeah. If the period is short, yeah, the company will be under pressure to generate large amount of cash to pay for the introduced product. Yeah. This can lead to inappropriate market strategy such as setting too high a price or allocating unnecessary high promotion budget for the product. Itu nombor dua. Second, target realistic perfect profit. Yeah. Company may just achieve a certain level of profit that is much more realistic and achievable. Yeah, mungkin just apa kan? May just want to achieve. Yeah. The knowledge of cost and demand functions that will perfect. In practice, realistic profit is measured in actual percentage terms. Yeah, kalau kata RM 20 million or 20% of the average cost by property type. Yeah, so they may set certain maybe the top management lah. They set realistic profit. Tapi when they set this profit, then maybe over time dia tengok dah in the market berapa actually. The return that profit that you can actually get from particular development. Because through experience and through the past apa lah, development that has been done. Yeah. Achievement profit is to be based on market and city study. Hopefully you'll be doing this in your property development and apa kan, market apa ni, market ni, course on market study, market research, and based on expectations, of annual growth, assuming the past trend will continue. Okay, thirdly, objective, ini is common lah, survival. May take many forms. Yeah, companies to stay out of difficult economic periods. Now is the period during COVID-19. Yeah. You don't see developers now. Kalau baca lah artikel dan paper this what we can gather lah. Sebab none of the developers, I'm sure kalau kita tanya dia takkan respond and jawab. Yeah. Basically kalau tengok dalam this paper ni, they will be saying that they are just trying to market what the units that they currently have. They will observe and see the current situation and see whether things improve before they start up new development. I feel like that is what the typical developers will be saying. Yeah, they should stick to long-term survival, and price can play a vital role as it can be changed in order to keep product flowing out and cash flowing in. Yeah. For long-term survival, lower than market pricing policy or priority price for better quality can foster the goodwill of the company. I don't know. I'm not so sure. I've not actually monitored whether developers are actually reducing the prices of their company development that are not happening. But I do see for second purchase houses, second hand, new development punya ni. You could see houses punya prices quite competitive. Prices tend to be to reflect the current demand situation. Yeah, because of the difficulty of people who want to keep their job or then people have been retrenched from job, that kind of trend. Yeah. Fourth would be sales volume or market share. Price can be used as means of increasing sales volume on the basis of a simple demand law. Lower the price, the higher the quantity demanded. Kita belajar dalam economics. And prior product pricing of product may take its competitive pricing. Maintenance of market share in a highly competitive market may mean the price cannot be increased without the careful analysis of the market. Increasing market share may mean aggressive low pricing. And high market price is likely to attract switches from competing product. So maknanya kita kena always monitor. Would people be wanting to tapi semua I observe actually in property development, you kena monitor besides pricing, people may want to buy property for many other reasons. Yeah? You know, because is it near to transportation hubs? Yeah? Or is it near to amenities and facilities provided in that scheme? Yeah? Development scheme. So banyak lagi ya, yeah, tu. Not just a simple like just a consumer product, banyak ya. And ada tak attachment, personal attachment being put in ya by the potential consumers on property that like to buy. Dia nak duduk dekat dengan the family, current family ya, dan sebagainya. Yeah. And I think number 5 would be revenue and liquidity. Yeah. Objective of pricing. Investors under pressure to generate cash quickly since property, yeah, product life cycle is short, yeah, leading to a short lead time to capitalize new product before it's taken over by new products. Yeah. So cash flow pressure, sensitivity of fluctuating and most property developments have high operational costs. Yeah. So how can pricing help increase liquidity and revenue? If demand is elastic, yeah, the company may benefit more by reducing the price. Tapi I don't know, depend elastic lah for property. Would that be very quick change, yeah, when you change the price? Something you kena monitor. Tapi to me, it all depends, yeah, on many things. Would you think the loan rate sekarang, interest rate ni be attractive enough, yeah, for maybe the younger generation to buy houses, new houses, yeah, those people in the current housing punya segment want to switch from what they have now, yeah, maybe kan, maybe duduk apartment now pergi landed property, yeah, and for that change you kena tengok the ability of financing and many other factors, yeah. Developer do not have sufficient or reliable information on price sensitivity of demand. General approach to property and to price property products not too far from the average price of similar products in the market. So only sebab macam kita buat comparison method of valuation. Kita compare in the market. That's what I think you nampak kan ini. Because you want to actually capture. Cuma tu lah, if you have done your segmentation and positioning well, then you to be able to strategize and everything. Because I could see some developers are very successful in their own development, yeah, because they do a lot of market research. Okay, maybe you like to also look into stimulating demand, yeah, encourage property buyers to reach, yeah, developers who offer relatively low price product. Product positioning is also important because price can be used to enhance product image, promote product use, create awareness and other positioning objectives. You may also create product visibility in the market. Yeah? Normally, developer who wish to gain market position will use low price of PV to gain sales and market value. Dulu at one time, yes, I could see that. Yeah, tapi at current moment, you know, I don't know. Yeah, it's quite difficult after because you see a new development also coming up, which is developed by not the the big companies. Yeah. And I could see the pricing that they're offering especially, eh, tapi mainly kat Kuala Lumpur saya nampak mainly developing apartments and condominium lah. Yeah, kalau yang low price tu kita tengok like affordable range, saya tengok pricing dalam Kuala Lumpur ni is around 300,000, yeah, for apartments. That's what dia apalah, because incentives are also being looked into by the government, yeah, to cater for this segment, yeah, of affordable housing punya range, yeah. It's a very hot topic at one time for the housing ni. By Prima also like to come in, then many other ni kan, many other developers also. In my study last year when I visited Johor and Melaka, yeah, to look into what would be the strategy. Kan? For Melaka is good, yeah, because the state coordinated well. Yeah, with the developers and mainly developers yang develop kan properties in Melaka are just local developers, yeah, yang biasa buat development in Melaka as opposed of the big developers lah coming into Johor or other parts of Pulau Gadis, yeah. So the state sort of rather maybe memang pantau ya the prices that they put up ya dalam apa development so that it can cater the needs of those who want to live in Melaka. Something which I thought mah was good ya, because I was asking to the apa lah, to the apa Melaka punya something the authority lah, and we went to the site visit. So something which I thought, you know, it's good. I think kita kena ada many things ya, policy so not comes in ya, when it comes to housing development ya. Okay, price competition, when look at pricing competition, ya, price competition is competition that relies solely on the manipulation of the product prices, ya. So always related to whether the firm uses a higher, lower, equal price, ya. Of a way to attack competitors, or position away ya, from the direct competition. So important to market for product which are not recently, such as median cost, ya. And price competition is succeed if the competitor cannot be easily match the price of the particular product. All depends, ya. Price ini kalau, tapi saya nampak high-end punya product, ya, because the study that I did was on the property overhang situation, ya, in Malaysia. Ada apa overhang ni maknanya rumah-rumah yang tak terjual, ya. Saya nampak rumah yang tak banyak tak terjual service apartment. High price service apartments, in terms of the pricing. So something which I think we got to be very wary in wanting to sell, kalau besok jadi estate agent on marketing the service apartment. So be sure and be wary of what actually you are actually putting out in the market and how what the things it can contain, of the service apartment. So saya tak nak beli service apartment. We can have excess money. It's worth trying to find out kenapa. What the feature of service apartment as compared to normal apartments and condominium. Kalau you all can explain that to me nanti. Most developer use non-price competition as marketing strategy. In property marketing, product differentiation, creating distinct product differentiation in terms of quality, is an example of non-price competition. And is very popular. So how can you differentiate your product different from your competitor is something which I think most of the developer is trying to adopt lah. Macam-macam strategy is trying to show what you can do, but what they are providing dan sebagainya, especially the big competitor, big developers. Okay, question to be asked, how would property developer set the target, the tactic to price the product? So pricing strategy can take into consideration of the quantitative or the pricing formula or qualitative. But the final price decision depends on the judgmental assessment impact of the given price strategy. You can drop yang kita have tu ada. Kita have mention about the new product. Saya dah mention the new product punya strategy. You can use the high price approach, skimming. Low price approach would be penetration, by it can preempting significant share of the market. Okay, these are profiling at one time suggested this four pricing strategy for costing product. They mention of high active, high passive, low active and low passive. Untuk apa, solution apa kita boleh gunakan untuk prestige development, there's a small target market, for resort living, high cost product, untuk high active. High passive, high price with non-price factors. Say dah diverse dan boleh juga kita letak for resort living dan sebagainya. But itulah, at one time I went to visit a site in Johor whereby they bought a resort type of development. Very nice actually. Ada bungalows, apartments that they had actually itu. Now I wonder actually what is the performance of that development in Johor. Nanti saya tengok share you. Kan okay. At one time mesti saya tengok ni ada istilah for there. Whereby ada tempat naik kuda, where you could use the lake dan sebagainya. Low active price is the main factors in purchase decision. Existence of high market competition, and company has cost advantage and strong product position. It's being used dalam medium cost housing, or maybe some commercial industry properties. Low passive would be small companies with lower cost feature. Dia bukan seperti kata low passive fee kan, maybe low cost housing dan sebagainya. Kalau so, low active would be maybe one use for affordable houses juga at the moment. So, these are some suggestions by Prof. Hamid actually for the pricing strategy for property. Okay, in terms of the basic pricing method, the method that can be adopted, ada lima. Tadi strategi, saya cakap pasal method. So, this are five various methods that can be adopted. Okay, first is cost plus and markup pricing. Methods dia determine profit margin to the full unit cost of production and distribution. Okay, example, you can use cost plus, maknanya what would be the cost of you constructing a single story house, and you put in a maybe a profit margin sikit, between 20%, atau use a basic markup formula, markup the price, what would be the average unit cost over one minus the expected rate of return. So, maybe dapat, jadi korang sama, about kan, within the price range. Cost plus market price also can determine as using unit variable cost plus your fixed cost and expected sales unit. So something which can fix apa yang kita fix lah. Variable translate directly with the output. And unit cost, the cost per unit will be to the cost per output. Okay, then you could also use break-even pricing. Utilize concept of fixed and variable cost enable developer to get the implication of the price volume alternative. Break-even analysis involves fixed cost to a product at determined rate. The first product will absorb the first total fixed cost. So you need to compute the total cost structure by adding variable cost incurred at different levels of output to the fixed cost. The fixed cost at $5,000 and the unit variable cost of $80,000. Total cost will be $100,000 plus the $100,000 per unit tadi. Where Q is the number of units produced. I think kita dah kenal you all to have this dalam economics as well or belajar apa lagi Probably I think something where I actually learn in my economics punya syllabus The marginal pricing is adopted by economists. They ignore the fixed cost and concentrate the shift between variable and revenue. So, analysis of contribution of product, not only to the fixed one, but to the variable marketing cost and profit. The variable unit cost of building certain type will be $50,000. And then product is sold at $95,000. So, the contribution is 45%. So, method is not used in most property development as difficult to work out the marginal contribution of each product. Kita tak nampak would be adding on of the margin dekat property product susah sebab kita nampak kita ada the construction stage being involved dalam kita menyiapkan satu rumah. Other pricing techniques would be cost plus modified market condition. The firm may consider selling a high price after considered the market condition. Than the expected demand for product exceed the target break-even volume. Kita tengok, kita modify. Tengok di market condition. Or market comparison is also very it depends on supply demand and competition. And technique set price according to what the market will buy. So the market, the market prices sold properties are analyzed using property type. Use competitive pricing method. So the developer also compare the cost of production against similar product in the market and the to compare cost of production against similar competing product in the market. Similar product yang ada as well as competing product, they compare the cost and all. And baru dia determine how much 1 to 10. So this Prof. Hamid also went to interview developers. And found out many developers adopt cost plus modified by market condition method as a means to push housing policies as housing prices. Those who claim to have adopted market approach have also checked the cost structure first. Selalu dia akan tengok cost and compare whether the production cost exceed the average market price. Combining this, you can decide whether to deliver new product at full or slightly below or higher market price depending on the demand condition. So all this has got to be analyzed yeah, by the developer first, and there will be the in-house unit will be doing this. So all of this, they got surveys, so mainly use cost plus, yeah, or cost plus modified dengan market condition. Break even tu tak ada, tak nak many are using that. And they always will always pantau and monitor the market condition. Okay, that is on pricing. Hopefully everybody is okay dah satu jam sebenarnya saya bercakap tentang price. You all okay tak? Rasanya boleh. Boleh ni. Pagi-pagi ni dah berpuasa sekali. Hopefully everybody is apa ni. Nanti saya nak. Saya nak panggil ni. Bolehkah? Siapa-siapa ni yang ada? Saya tak nampak. Siapa who I call? Ayah. Tiny ada?
Yes, doctor.
Okay. Are you apa? Would you be able to absorb semua tu? Banyak ya, banyak actually what I covered this morning.
Kan? Need some time to digest.
Boleh, I take some time. Hopefully you'll be able, tak apa, pelan-pelan ya. Because the thing is, I went through the strategies ya. Strategy for pricing. Okay, what do you mean by price? You got to understand, kan? Apa dia price? Kalau the definition of price, what it is? What does price represent? Yeah, that is very important. And then when it comes to product punya pricing, property product pricing, nampak ada banyak strategy that can be adopted. And what are the things that are being apa kan by apa ni. So tak apa kan, try to apa, go to balik-balik. That's why it's very important kalau boleh do the apa kan, the tutorial questions that I post. Then you can always go back again and again and apa kan, tengok balik. Yeah. Tapi pricing ni nobody actually want to review. Kalau saja developer, they wouldn't want to share with you. Yeah. Sebab takut kita publish and everybody knows how they set the price. Nobody wants to share with you kita sebenarnya actually. Yeah. Okay, what else ya? Apa lagi? Yeah, so, apa ni? So, the thing is, next section will be on promotion ya. Saya nak just go through promotion. Because this, kalau kita dah 4 piece ni, 4 marketing mix ni, saya dah give an overall overview ya, earlier dalam my apa? Lecture 4 ya. For you to just be able to know kan, what's there within the 4 piece. All this sekarang, all dah masuk banyak-banyak lagi piece lain ke dan sebagainya. But I just want you all to really understand what the 4 piece represent. Ya, yeah? Banyak. But tengok buku marketing, banyak lagi. Banyak element which I like to share. Kalau you tengok, especially I love Philip Kotler punya buku lah. Eh? Because he has done extensive study on marketing. Banyak dan sebagainya. And now you tengok the way that you market product also dah berbeza-beza. There's online shopping, there's dan sebagainya. Online marketing, ya. Yeah? Benda macam tu. And accessibility also has come in. Yeah, how do you help to do sustainable marketing yeah, dan sebagainya. So these are new concepts ya. Yeah. Because sekarang kita nampak IR 4.0 has come in. Ya, yeah, kita tengok sekarang people also now so much into climate change. Ya. Yeah. So banyak benda-benda isu yang kita can now be aware of. And see kan what will be the new set of changes to behavior, to values. Dan sebagainya. Yeah. So things will change over time. Yeah. So you got to pick up and see how that can change the behavior of consumers over time as well. It's something which I always like to understand. Yeah. So next we look at promotion. Promotion is the last actually of the mix that saya introduce for the 4 piece. Yeah. What is the definition of promotion? It's just a collection of personal and non-personal marketing communication means which encourage consumer to buy a particular product. Yeah. So, dia ada the keyword di sini apa dia? Communication. Yeah. So nampak banyak tu what will apa? Zoom down to see marketing communication. Yeah. And means, yeah. Cara mana komunikasi pemasaran ada. So that kita nak consumer beli produk. Yeah. So inform people about claim benefits of particular product and persuade them to buy it. Ya, kita nak kata paksa tak paksa lah. Kita nak pujuk. Yeah. combines various marketing communication means. Communication means study in an integrated strategy to influence purchasing behaviors of the target group. Yeah, so main objective kita is to increase sales. Kita nak naikkan jualan. Okay, other objective would be communicate the product, capture customer, commit them into buying, speed up sales process, widen information about product, awareness, and use the tool, promotion as a tool of competition with other developers. This is the way kita nak promosi, cara promosi digunakan. Promotion process kita belajar ni macam mainan, people percent messages lah. Ataupun ingat tak main apa, pin kosong, dekat dengan kali ada orang bagi all baik, main tak saya main that game many years ago. Pin kosong, you tap kali, one person cakap and the other person letak kat telinga. Kan? I don't know whether he can really actually apa dengar tidak ni, the message that being sent. Atau you main apa musical chair. Kan? Itulah. Ataupun ni main whereby kan, you are sending a message with one person and eventually you ada maybe a few person in between, so that the message can be sent to the last person in that group. Bukannya balik original message and the last person that receive the message tu apa sebenarnya message that being sent. Tengok communication process tu, the from the sender to receiver, in between tu the encoding, the channel that is being sent, the decoding tu apa kan happens. Adakah message yang mula-mula nak dihantar tu diterima oleh penerima dengan makna dan apa kan pemahaman yang sama. Kadang-kadang the letter will write as well. Make sure that you write it in a way, in a manner that people would eventually faham apa kita punya objektif. Kadang-kadang itulah communication ni actually a very apa juga tricky and apa complicated punya way of delivering messages. Goals and task of promotion, kita nak actually sampai kepada target audience. We want either to inform, remind and persuade. The goals of doing promotion. Okay, the criteria set for promotion objective. It should be measurable and concrete, be based on sound research, be realistic and receive the overall marketing plan and relate specific marketing objective. So, ini objektif promosi lah. Kita boleh ukur, kita ada some penyelidikan yang mantap boleh buat. Lepas kita tahu siapa kita punya target audience, siapa kita punya orang yang akan terima. Jadi, kita boleh realistik. Jangan buat promosi entah tak ada sebarang objektif, so that you can reinforce the marketing plan dalam pemasaran dan relate kita punya objektif pemasaran. Promosi dan pemasaran berbeza, promosi dan pemasaran. Objektif can also example you nak inform awareness, increase the top level of may from 15 to 24 to persuade, because you nak change the attitude. Okay, tapi you can increase tadi, you can ukur tadi from what percent to 90% or to remind the people that benda tu sedang tidak ada dan sebagainya, kat mana kita boleh jumpa, that kind of information dalam promosi tersebut. So when you create a promotion plan per promosi, you want to analyze your marketplace. Identify target market, siapa kita nak buat promosi ni? Pada siapa? Pada babies, babies tak faham lah. Sebab mak-mak babies dan sebenarnya kalau barang babies. Kalau untuk dose yang high fashion produk kepada the younger generation. So, this are identify target market. Set promotion objective. Develop promotion budget, that is very critical. Sebab kalau tak ada budget, you may not be able to do the promotion. And choose your promotion mix lah. Nanti mix tu aku cakap mereka. Tadi ada marketing mix ada. Promotion mix pun ada. So, criteria for efficient and effective promotion. Promotion objective mesti ada. And budget mesti specify. It does not attempt to do what other product units can do better. Yeah. The best promotion for achieving the objective. Yeah. Promosi yang terbaik, cara yang terbaik untuk capai objektif kita. It has maximum effect of, for the discourse. Consistent the behavior pattern. Consistent the product image. Yeah. It gets attention. Simple and clear and easy to understand. Uses emotional and rational appeal to self-interest. Yeah. Bigger, decent, honest, reward on all whom is success depend. Yeah, maknanya kalau kita buat efektif promosi, yang success will come back to the organisation lah. Terus will create the promotion punya campaign dan sebagainya. Yeah. That's why it's the company lah sebab dia punya produk. Ramai orang beli sebab people are more aware eh, and you help to proceed your potential purchases to buy your product. Yeah. Okay, these are the mix. Pasal saya tanya promotion mix of promotion tu, ini dia. Yeah. Advertising. Yeah. Direct marketing. Public relations. Personal selling. Sales promotion. Yeah. And what they are dalam ni lah. Yeah. Advertising. Ada biasa kita nampak advertising kan. TV, radio, billboard. Yeah. Dalam your kan dalam social media. Dalam web lah. Online. People tend to do advertising. Nah, personal selling, okay. This one macam orang jual insurance, as well as acting general negotiator. Yeah, you do personal selling. Yeah? You could go and try to convince yeah someone to purchase an idea through the use of oral presentation. Yeah, ataupun nak jual lah software datang. Atau datang people that we come and help apa to internet show. Yeah? The use of the particular software for your particular company. Yeah. Access promotion, your media or non-media marketing communication. From termin limited time to increase consumer demand and improve market demand. Yeah. Could use to contest, product sample, trade show, exhibition. Nampak kan people just want to apa ni? Public relations, yeah, paid internet apa? Konti saya nak lihat ni pula. Yeah. Sorry. Paid internet stimulation, yeah. Stimulation of a supply or product or service or business unit by planting the news about it. You plan your news about your product. Buatlah beri presentasi sikit ke dalam newspaper, TV, video presentation, seminar, ya, PR. Ada kit dia sekali, ya, press kit. Kalau you buat apa kan, dia ambil. TV punya apa, punya announcement dan sebagainya. Ya, kena panggil press, come in. Soalnya, itulah produk dia buat apa, popularitas dia launch produk, dia panggil minister, dia panggil maybe somebody from the ministry, dan sebagainya. I don't want to cakap something, tapi dalam tu dia cuba nak promote this particular development, ya. Menteri perumahan ya, selalunya dipanggil oleh developers ya, to come in and apa ni, help. Direct marketing is a channel agnostic form of advertising that allows businesses or non-profit to communicate straight to the customer. This advertising technique such as mobile messaging, email, direct to consumer website, online display ad, catalog exhibition, promotion letters, outdoor advertising. Yang ada tempat flyers dalam punya post box ya, orang apa ni. Orang datang untuk ini, ya, dia dapat flyers. Okay, one elements of promotion are most useful. Pada bawah elemen tu ada awareness, yeah, knowledge, liking, preference, conviction, purchase. Kalau boleh kita nak purchase lah. These are suggestion, advertising. Yeah. Advertising either not or inefficient. So, your purchase kadang-kadang orang kata personal selling and sales promotion will be better. So, depends on what type of product tu ni, ya. Promotion to use, ya. Yeah. So, you must always try to see what would be the promotional problem or issue like tackle. You nak penetrate customer, you use maybe advertising, personal selling. Ya. Yeah. Kalau you nak ambil customer first impression, you buat apa free gift lah selalunya, kan. Yeah. Open day, show house punya ni, open day, semua datang on Saturday, Sunday. Kalau you nak increase consumption purchase, you buat kasih discount, free gift kalau you beli satu dapat, beli dua dapat, price of this one, sound price dan sebagainya. Top 10, long-term loyalty. Strategic promotion juga upon service of the competitor, whereby kalau kita sebut saya pergi di school, saya dapat maybe vouchers, ya, ataupun so boleh jadi member of Ion or Jusco. Sudah pergi-pergi dapatlah some points when you purchase, and at the end itu you can apa, redeem the points for something else. Masih jadi long term loyalty nya apa, customer of that particular outlet. Yeah. Survive declining market, yeah. Specific active promotion strategy, adjusting to consumer affordability. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, itu saya affect promotion ni. Saya selalu tanya. Ini jangan terkejut ya. Factor that affect promotion mix. Okay, maybe the nature of the product. Macam mana nature tu? Kan kita adakah dia kan orang selalu nak beli makan rare ke dan sebagainya. Stages product life cycle, adakah dia introductory, mature kan dan sebagainya, dah mature ke kan. Target marketing characteristic, you're targeting at consumer yang biasa ataupun industrial or business, ya. Type buying decision, adakah produk tu memang staple punya produk or something yang dia bayar, beli sekali-sekala. And fund available lah berapa duit dia ada, eh? And push strategies that you'd like to take into account. So this would be factors that can affect your promotion mix. Because either nak guna apa, advertising ke, nak guna sales promotion ke dan sebagainya. Ya. Yeah. Yeah, steps in advertising, saya tak ada, saya tanya this one, yeah, because it's just something for you all to know if you do advertising. Yeah. Setting objective, decide your budget, yeah, your team, apa you nak, yeah, message you nak buat, product yang nak guna, yeah, information, yeah, select media, berapa kan exposure intensity, evaluate your advertising effectiveness. Is something kalau you nak do kan, steps in advertising. Saya takkan, I don't want to ask you kan, what be details of how you do advertising. Okay, and types of advertising media and strength and success, these are contoh sebenarnya. Kalau you guna newspaper, sekarang you tengok eh, siapa actually reading newspaper. Television, siapa tengok newspaper. Yeah, direct mail, radio, magazine, outdoor. Banyak juga medium yang lain, ya, yeah, dalam social media and kind of thing. AIDA and hierarchy of effect. AIDA stands for attention, interest, desire and action. And okay, these are kena study apa kan, list of events that may occur when a consumer engage with advertisement. Yeah, kalau buat advertisement, okay, then AIDA comes in. Whether the advertisement create the awareness, interest, desire and action finally, yeah, that prompts the customer now to purchase. Whether your AIDA is effective or tidak, yeah. So, okay, media types of advertising, institutional advertising and product advertising. Yeah, saya takkan not too much, just for you all to know. Saya takkan tanya banyak tentang all this apa kan, what really in detail of advertising. Yeah, sebab advertising ni can be much more that you just see here. Yeah. And the appearance lah, when you want to advertise, apa appealing ke dia buat? Health ke? Love and romance ke? Nampak love and romance dalam advertising for apa ni? For minyak wangi. Tengoklah, ya. Yeah. Convenience, fun and pleasure dan sebagainya. Apa appealing punya themes that you like to use, ya, to promote the product. PR. Okay, banyak developer juga guna PR, ya, whereby they will plant news dalam newspaper, magazine ke, radio presentation tu. Tapi cuma depending on who listens to them lah, and which channel that you like to apa. So you remember tadi, who are your target market? Target segment that you trying to enter, ya? Yeah? And siapa ni, this is where you must focus, ya? Yeah? And apa, try to reach out to those potential purchasers or buyers, ya? Yeah? Normally, big companies will have PR officer, ya? Yeah? Publication officer that handles the news, ya? Yeah? So this when tools used by PR professional, ya? Yeah? Product placement, event, yeah, website, sebagainya. Sales promotion, okay. Promotion ni penting sebab kita kadang-kadang nampak, ya. Okay, dia macam ni ada tiga type. Incentive, professional supervising, informational activities yang mungkin boleh digunakan oleh developers. Nampak developers use mainly use show houses, but kadang-kadang dia juga pergi to apa exhibition ya. Trade exhibition saya nampak selalunya dekat KLCC ataupun Mid Valley ya. And they can also do other form of advertising ya, besides the rest lah, advertising ke person selling advertising ya. So the three main objective of the promotion, dia nak communicate, nak kasih incentive and invite buyers ya, to consider a certain purchase decision. Dan you look into sales promotion. Okay, this are categories of the consumer sales promotion consumer which I don't think we would have that too much dalam property development. Personal selling, this one estate agent comes in the process of helping trading one or more prospect to purchase a good or service or to add on the idea to the use of other presentation. This where your sales meeting bila juga yang kan potential purchaser ataupun kan you would like to sell, do your meeting. This kalau you ada kan estate agent, ada negotiator, dia ada training, ada incentive program dan sebagainya. Yeah. So then the task of this representative to be very important. You must try to identify siapa prospect and inform dia, negotiate, persuade and effectively. Ni something which you got to be picked up by that person yang pandai ya. I do know of a particular person which was told to me by the MD of TBRE, WTW. Ya. Kata dia dalam company dan the one particular lady who does sales of a particular property and she commission dia banyak. Sebab dia punya close program, dia punya ni dalam doing sales tu memang million. Wow, tak dengar pun. So she can just complete one transaction per year or for some month, that's it. You can just keep quiet after that. Tapi saya wonder lah what the strategy that this particular person does ya. Yeah, for her to complete that million dollar punya transaction. Ya, yeah, because million dollar dapat banyak ni lah, banyak commission. Ya. Yeah. This when about this planning and you have to do can control, yeah. And you must do target, cost control, increasing sales is very important. Nah, this is a task of this management. Saya pernah tanya, yeah, because this relates to doing as an agency, yeah. Whereby dalam being the agent in putting up your team, yeah, of your estate negotiator. You would want to see set sales objective and you have a structure of your sales force. Determine the sales force size, you develop compensation plan, how much you like pay, then you create sales force. Kalau you nak ni lah, berapa banyak kan being now, dia buat kan apa, okay ni kan letak berapa kan, you cerita bawa estate agent. Ini dia tanya Encik Puan Sharifah Azhar. Do some training for your sales force, I think Encik Ishak Ismail ya, from IMG Global ya, Encik buat training. They motivate your sales force, manage your turnover, evaluate your sales force punya performance tadi and tengoklah you know, the success of that. So many asset management companies does this, yeah? I do know that. So basic steps in selling process pun saya selalu tanya, whereby you want to create, generate your sales lead, qualify the sales lead, make the sales approach. Maknanya lead ni siapa prospect tu, rasa seorang yang nak beli. The people just tanya, boleh tak saya nampak itu semua, saya nak beli rumah. Then you try to convince the person yang showed the interest tadi in purchasing the property that you going to sell. Yeah. Okay, making the sales presentation kalau boleh bawa pergi visit and what not, nak tunjuk rumah, buat open house. And your objection is something kena pandai. I don't know what that I'm good at that. Oh, tak nak lah sebab ni, sebab itu, sebab tu, you kena kata tackle that one and come with good, good answers. And close the sale and do follow up after the sale lah, when they're satisfied with your services so that they can recommend you to another person you want to buy, look out for rumah ataupun jual property juga. Yeah. Yeah, advertising versus person selling is important kalau ya, that has a value, normally beli rumah memang. Ya, kita ada duit banyak kena keluar. Customer product, there are few customers. The product is actually complex. Customers are then geography concentrated. Ya. Besides information is more important if the product has low value, analyze product, many customers, product is simple to understand, customer and people. Tapi pula in terms of property ni, you could also do a bit of small and super promotion as well, ya. Macam saya nampak super promotion being done, ya, so that all this apa ni, exhibition halls and whatnot. Then, tapi person selling ni, that actually goes to new product. Person selling ni is more towards the second hand product probably, ya. Tapi most developer pun sekarang dah engage, ya, personal selling, ya, to being done to product yang dia nampak susah nak jual. Ya, probably itu nak convince people, ya, to promote more of the value of what the product can offer. Ya. Direct marketing finally, interactive marketing system of marketing uses more of one or more advertising media to affect a measurable response and location forming basis for creating or further developing an ongoing direct relationship with your merchant and customer, maybe to direct mail, direct response or telemarketing. This is just apa kan, ada apa direct way of marketing being done, yeah, because you have the interactive system of marketing. Yeah. Okay, that's it. Yeah. So basically nampak, yeah, quite banyak benda yang kita cover today. Saya boleh, ya. Yeah. Oh, this something which actually something that's a lot to cover. Tak apa, yeah. Because saya dah put up saya akan letak recorded, yeah, of recording of the lecture for you to understand better. Tapi to me, I understand that will be very important for you to tackle doing maybe your assignments, other assignments yang ada, or maybe those yang attempt to do marketing dalam your dissertation, your thesis. Ya, kalau siapa dia buat aspect of marketing tak? I don't know, maybe these are things that we want to observe, and why you trying to, apa ni, konsep-konsep yang kita boleh letakkan dalam kita memahami tentang pemasaran. Ada apa-apa soalan tak? Anyone would like to ask question? So ni ada dua perkara yang kita guna tu untuk yang kita dah apa for today. Kita tengok pricing, kita look at promotion. Nah, there's a lot tu apa ni. Saya tak dengar apa-apa ni. Ada orang ada dekat on screen tak lagi ke atau anybody would like to ask anything? Nak digest dulu. Besok saya boleh tanya, ya. Okay, tomorrow I have a meeting at 10, ya. Yeah. Hopefully it can be finished by 11. Kalau saya terlambat sikit, so you all try to go through dulu the questions that I post dalam Spectre, tutorial question. Nanti saya akan tanya. And then I put one case, ya, yeah, nanti for us to discuss as well for tomorrow's session. So be prepared, ya, yeah, go through of what we have gone through today. And then look at the case study yang saya akan letak kat website dekat UN Spectrum, and then kita akan discuss of how we go through and see, ya, the questions post, ya, dalam the case and the dan tutorial. Boleh, ya? Rasanya okey tak? Saya tak dengar apa-apa.
Boleh.
Saya nampak Amira rajin jawab. And buatlah tutorial question. You also nampak lebih kurang dalam 13. 15, ya, yeah, there's 37 of you all in the class. Buat, because if you attempt to do, you nampak kan certain thing you tak sure, you will try to find answers for that. It's a bit of doing early revision for yourself, ya, yeah, sebenarnya. For you trying to attempt to do that, at least you try to say, oh, okay, saya faham, ya, yeah, tentang konsep pemasaran ni. Pemasaran ni banyak, ya, yeah. Imagine, ada one course in marketing, tapi kita punya kecil kan, lah, belajar marketing dalam 6-7 minggu saja. Which I think is a bit apalah, eh, terlampau ni. Nanti people ask you, konsep of marketing you understand, kata, tapi itulah, to know more, I think you got to be in the market, to be able to understand better, in the job dan sebagainya, pick up lah nanti, understanding marketing. Tak apalah, you like to know more nanti, baca more, read more of the concept of marketing, ya. Yeah? Actually, to me, marketing is a very interesting ni. Area to know more, because it affects our normal life, yeah? Kita apa beli barang, kita tengok macam mana, kenapa dia tak harga ni, and then tanya sendiri lah. Dan saya pun and all relates as well to things yang biasa kita yang common, like macam buying a property, tanya why is the property price as such, yeah? Because lokasi ke, because of the amenities and whatnot being offered dan sebagainya. Nampak, eh? Banyak lagi perkara lain yang mungkin akan boleh menetapkan harga, harga tanah kita. So this is cuma I'm just applying the main concept of marketing just a bit, ini for understanding how it relates to property for a start lah, ya. There are many more and things that we can study more or explore more later, ya. Then you dah faham the basic concept of marketing. Okay. Okay, saya stop di situ aja so that you all can take a break, ya. Yeah? About half an hour more for your next class. Saya ni, hopefully insyaAllah kita cuba jumpa besok, ya. Yeah? I'll try. Ini my meeting dengan saya ni ada. Saya ni asyik sibuk meeting.
Saya nak tanya.
Apa? Tanya apa?
Assignment tu kan, kalau terlalu banyak words tak apa ke?
Kalau more tak apalah. Kalau you cannot apa kan boleh letak je tak apa. It's okay. As long you put in all information that is required, it's okay. Jangan letak question, kan, information tu yang nampak banyak tapi sebenarnya dia tak menjawab pun what is required, ya, by the apa instruction. Ya, itu yang penting. Insyaallah apa yang minta, ya.
Doktor Yasri.
Yes.
Nak tanya bagi task 2 do assignment itu supporting document masuk apa?
Oh, tu tanya Cik Sharifah Azhar nanti, ya.
I tanya dia tapi Puan Sharifah belum
tak respon.
Tak respon. Nanti saya tanya boleh. Macam ni boleh minta tolong Toto Yasmin tolong remindkan dia.
Oh, saya remind dia. Okay. You already dia, you dah tanya dia, ya. Okay, saya remind.
Sudah tanya dia.
Okay, sure. Okay. Saya tanya. Okay. Just keep me updated lah, ya. Okay. And then just maybe put messages dalam the kan our group tu. So I can just follow up. Ya, takut saya terlepas pandang tu dan sebagainya. Do that, ya. Do that to me. Ya, yeah, nanti saya cuba tanya dia. Okay, anything else tak? Ada apa nanti, just apa ni? From apalah, anything dalam kita punya group. Tak be able to follow up when I can, ya. Yeah. Saya cuba ni, follow up nanti. Okay, so that, you covered that. Nanti hopefully by next week saya look into strategies, marketing strategy. Strategy tu lah kata, macam dulu we do masa many years ago, ya. Yeah, when we were doing, integrated project. We do ask students to do strategies, marketing strategy, ya. Yeah? So that katalah we look at development, what would be the marketing strategy. So what they eventually put, that they put the 4 P's. Memang the 4 P's actually memang integrated into the marketing strategy. But in developing the strategy, what you need to do is that you got to do the apalah. The SWOT analysis, and then decide how to segmentation. How to do the target marketing and positioning for your product dan sebagainya to the SWOT analysis sebagainya, the internal, the external punya environment punya analysis, yeah. So that's very important for you to understand and get the information first, yeah, for you to come up with that strategy, yeah. The 4 P's come in now, because you determine, okay, what the product would be, kan, most suitable, what the price range that you can set, kan, what form of promotion that you can do to to persuade people to go and buy and close the deal dan sebagainya. Ya. Yeah. So before doing that, you kena ada benda upfront dulu for you to decide, kan. Yeah, that is the whole aspect of doing that strategy, yeah, marketing strategy. So saya biar nampak you all faham, ya. Yeah. Okay, so dah macam dah banyak je ni. Okay, insyaAllah I'll try to be fast dalam my meeting tomorrow and meet you all by then, ya. Yeah, and then you go to the total question, ya. Yeah. Okay. Sudah dekat sini saya ada berapa? 7 orang. 10 orang tak datang. Tak apa, nanti apa. So hopefully I'll see most of you all tomorrow. Yeah? All of you all actually tomorrow and more. Kalau boleh, ya. Yeah? Can we have some discussion. Okay, terima kasih banyak. Selamat buka siapa yang puasa hari ini. Selamat puasa, ya. Yeah? Okay, insyaAllah kita jumpa besok. Okay, thank you. See you all tomorrow.
Thank you, Doktor.
Thank you, Doctor.
Okay, bye.
Thank you, Doctor. Yeah.